Hello friends, this is Chandrakant and I welcome you on this very bright Monday morning in the Doctor Speak. And our guest doctor today is Dr. Pooja Bedi. So let me welcome Dr. Pooja without further ado.
Good afternoon, CK. Thank you so much.
Yes, doctor, I think today we would like to discuss about something related to the mental health. And there is a lot of confusion about the bipolar syndrome. And people don't seem to understand what is bipolar, what triggers it, and what are the symptoms, in fact, to identify those symptoms. So I think it is a good subject for us to discuss. So the first question would be from my side is, what is a bipolar? I think if you can explain this in very simple layman term, for our viewers to understand, it will be great.
Yes, definitely. CK, as the term indicates, that bi is two and the polar means poles. So this disorder basically is associated with the two different apart poles of mood swings, where suddenly a person is having a very hyperactivity mentally, physically, which can actually lead to very relentless decisions. And then there is a phase when this person comes down. So, in a very, very low, or we say hypomaniac manner, and the intensity becomes very low in terms of energy, in terms of talking, in terms of having meals, don't want to talk to someone. So, bipolar disorder is basically a disorder which is associated with the mood swings. So, the mood swings basically are of two types. Either the person becomes very, very hyper or becomes very, very hypo. And the reason for the same is very difficult to come out with. So the major reason we come across is it can run in the families. We have seen it if somebody has a bipolar, which is very, very remarked, or you can say markably seen in a particular generation, is definitely getting inherited in the other generation. So that is one of the factors. But besides this, if we say the social factors are there, you can say the some sort of chemical incoordination in the brain can also lead to bipolar disorder. And unfortunately, it starts at a younger age. And as a parent or as a, you can say, healthcare professionals, we are not able to diagnose them right bang on time. So if we are able to do it, if the parents are more aware, if the society is more aware why the child is undergoing sudden ups and downs, mood swings are there, hormones play definitely one factor into it. But the sudden and sudden low and sudden high in children, if it can be diagnosed at a very early age, it can be catered very nicely later on in the same cases. So I highly recommend that the pre-existing factors like ADHD, where the kids are very hyperactive, suddenly they start shouting and they behave very normal after a while, and then suddenly they become very low. So this kind of mood upsets, if the frequency is very high, going to a psychologist or to a psychiatrist or maybe to a health professional or maybe having a group therapy can really help a lot. So bipolar disorder is a very chronic illness marked by severe mood swings. It can affect both the genders, women and men, but women are more vulnerable because of many reasons. They get into the maniac mode for the longer durations, which make them more vulnerable for the episodes in the future. So it is actually a thing which is not catered very nicely in the society. So we need to be more aware about it.
So doctor, tell us, is this a disorder related to the age, or is it can happen to anyone at any time? What is the beginning, the first sign of having the bipolar syndrome?
Right. So the first thing is the age. Let's discuss about the age. It usually happens little later in the age. The early childhood, the indicators definitely they start popping up, like I mentioned, ADHD. It can actually, if left untreated or uncatered, can lead to a little severity. I'm not saying bipolar only, but maybe in any other form it can come up. But yes, many of the ADHD cases, sooner or later, you can say in the adulthood, it starts affecting the person. So not at an early age, bipolar starts affecting. And second is the age was the one thing that we were discussing. And second, I'm so sorry.
The second was, can it happen to a particular type of people or it can happen to anyone?
It can happen to anyone, but yes, people who are already having it and they can definitely give it to their coming generation. So genetic effect is there. But otherwise, there as such, there's no particular age group you can say which gets affected, or it is not a gender bias thing. It can affect anyone. But yes, the like alcohol abuse cases, or you can say substance abuse cases that are there, they are more vulnerable towards the bipolar or the mental health other issues that are there. So they are more vulnerable towards it.
The reason I asked this question is primarily because I wanted to bring clarity that this is not related to genes. It could affect anyone having difficult situation or highs and lows, as you mentioned. So I think that is one point that is clear now. We have also seen that this affects very popular people. You know, maybe, you know, we don't hear about them, you know, normal people, but we usually hear about the very successful people who are always in limelight and attracting media attraction. So does bipolar is a byproduct of becoming popular too soon, too early, or it could be non-related to your fame at all? You know, it can happen to anyone, whether you are a successful person or you are a normal person, it could still affect you. What are the reasons behind it?
If we are talking specifically to the people who are very, very successful and there's instant success is there, somehow I will say that the first reason in them is the drug or the alcohol abuse. So this is called as dual diagnosis. When the people who actually go very, very high and at a very high pace, they tend to suffer some kind of anxiety, you know, which they are very easily able to cater for it by themselves. So the pre or maybe some other kind of thing. So which is a pre-existing factor in them, along with, I would say, alcohol or drug abuse can definitely take a person towards a bipolar syndrome. And the sad part is, if it is left untreated, if it is left maltreated, or is misdiagnosed, and if the societal or the family support is not there, it can end up in a suicidal cases as well. So in the very, very extreme cases, yes, it can definitely lead to suicidal tendencies in the people. And to an extent, when people are very successful, they tend to get into bad habits. So I would say the plus of the bad habits and the pre-existing factors can definitely lead to it. But if we are talking just that the person is going high and suddenly sees a low, so the mood changes are there. So again, the factor is not that they are suddenly successful or instant success and the money flows in. No, that is not the reason. But yes, if the sudden low is there, if they are not able to stabilize their mood, they are not able to control their emotions, they're not able to control that disturbance that is coming for a transient phase, it can definitely lead to some or the other mental disorder, or maybe later on bipolar as well, because we see many cases ending up, unfortunately, with the life, you can say, attempt to suicide or suicide. So yes, it actually affects.
So Dr. Pooja, I'm not like a normal layman. As a layman, I understand there are three scenarios. One is at time of dire strait. Many times we feel superhuman, you know, we feel that there is an adrenaline rush and we start doing things like a superhuman. And at times, as you mentioned, there could be a suicidal tendency. So there is one scenario where you take a very difficult task and you probably finish it or perish doing that. Second is that for no reason, you want to just have a suicidal tendency. And third is a bipolar. What is the difference between these three? And my second part of the question is, is suicidal tendency is necessarily part of a bipolar, or a trigger from bipolar causes the suicidal tendency? I mean, if you can just explain this in more detail, so it will help our viewers to understand where they stand.
Yes. So coming to the first part of the question where you say that adrenaline rush can lead to such kind of mood swings, definitely it leads to some kind of mood swings. But look at the sports people or people like us. We are able to cater for those emotional disturbances very easily. We have to get into that ritual of getting back to the daily chores or the target that is there. So failures are part of life for everyone. So the sooner or later they accept, so the better is their mental health. So coming to the again to the first question, adrenaline rush, the moment we are able to cater for the ups and downs in life or in success or in terms of money, many people are able to do it. This is why the human race is surviving. So it has nothing to do with the bipolar till the time. So sports person, otherwise the moment they retire, so the adrenaline rush definitely goes down. So it never happens that in majority of the cases, they stay very normal, or people like us. So sudden fame, sudden money, till the time individual is able to control his ups and downs, he is not going to have very threatening kind of mental health issues or bipolar for sure. But coming to societal tendencies that people have, yes, bipolar has got a role. So this is the second part of question. So societal tendencies, it happens when the person is in extreme low, you can say. So we are very much aware that the anxiety, depression, societal pressures, familial pressures, career, money can all lead to these kind of tendencies. Or you can say, unfortunately, they mature as well into some kind of suicide, losing the life. But if you go towards the higher side of it, why the successful people, why the people are who are having money, so there's some kind of mental disturbance in the form of comorbidity, you say, or the pre-existing factor, you say, is already there, which is a very false notion in itself, because the bipolar, you can say, is running in the back and it is performing itself in a hypermaniac form. And in the hypermaniac form, when people are relentlessly deciding certain decisions, they can actually go for suicidal acts as well. So in both the cases, the suicide can happen because of the emotional low or emotional high as well. So we need to crack a balance. Somebody who is having these kind of tendencies, they definitely need a psychotherapy. It can be catered. Medications are also there. Counseling sessions are there. So the psychosocial therapies are there, which can actually help them out. And the third part of the question, that the bipolar is not that it always ends up in the suicide. But as I mentioned, that if it is associated with any kind of substance abuse, or you can say alcohol abuse, so if these factors are there, or drug abuse, you can say, people are taking drugs a lot these days, youngsters are taking a lot. So there's sudden mood changes that are there. In those mood changes, yes, they can definitely go for suicidal tendencies. But it's not that it is bipolar is highly marked with the societal tendency. But yes, if left untreated, as I mentioned, if left misdiagnosed, it can definitely lead to societal tendency. Because when they are in a very high mood, they are not able to decide certain things or make certain decisions in a very rational manner. So they somehow end up in these kind of unfortunate things.
I think the most important question is, how do you identify? I think if somebody is having a bipolar syndrome, first of all, he will also not understand that he is actually bipolar. And the people around him also will not know, you know, this guy is sometimes very very angry on small things, and sometimes he's not at all attentive on things. So these are very normal things, you know, which happens every day, maybe five times a day. How do you distinguish between a normal behavior and a bipolar behavior?
CCK, when it comes in a childhood phase, which I really insist, and majority of my talks and articles are on the childhood stage. So at that particular stage, since the bipolar does not manifest that early, but it exists in a very different and a pre-existing form like ADHD, which is pre-marked in children. You will see certain group of children who are very silent, they're okay, but they fight with their fellow friends, but then again, next day they are there. But again, you will be able to witness one odd child in the entire group or crowd, you say, who shrieks, who shouts, and then suddenly mellows down. You know, suddenly he will start or she will start beating the younger ones, and suddenly you will say there's a change is there. After a week, they are having, you know, friendship with them again. So this is very normal. If somebody is listening, this is very normal. It happens with my kids, somebody will say. But if the frequency of these episodes is very, very high or is very repetitive, then definitely we have to conclude or diagnose that particular childhood mental health issues are there with the child. So it's very important that you, we as a parent or society try to identify these kind of things in children. They suddenly start talking to you and then you will see there's abrupt change, then they don't want to talk to you, they are sitting in one corner. Probably they were very fond of reading or playing a certain sport and sudden changes there where they don't want to go out and play sports. So these are the indicators in children. When it comes to the adult, so specifically talking about the women, since they are more vulnerable for certain reasons, you'll see there are drastic changes in the mood. You see a female suddenly shouting. She is having a discussion, a very normal discussion with the family or with friends. Suddenly she'll just pop up in anger. Or you will say that after a while she mellows down as well. And then she becomes very normal, as though nothing has happened. So again, the thing is very normal. It happens sometime. But if the episodes are in frequency and repetitive mode, it needs to be catered. So if somebody is sitting alone, not talking to someone who was very extrovert, very jolly natured person, but suddenly you see their hobby has changed, they don't want to pursue their hobby anymore, or you say they have conflicting relations in their professional life, which was not there earlier, or they are crying very often. So it is a very marked indicator in the female. As far as men are concerned, they are more into the hyper side, to be very frank. So if we say, one of the example, if some particular person is a very good driver and this guy or this man tend to have frequency of accidents, so it is an indicator. I'm just citing one small example, though it is not 100% related to this particular thing, but a small example. Somebody is a good driver, suddenly he is meeting up with or ending up with many accidents frequently. So it can show some kind of relentless decisions in, that this guy is taking. So in men, if they are comparatively very less vulnerable compared to women, but both the genders are definitely affected with it. So the indicators are very clear. Suddenly you see a person is very jovial. During their high time, they tend to eat less food, because so much of energy is there. And they feel like they're very confident, they can do anything. And suddenly they make some very big targets for themselves. And then after a week or maybe say after a couple of years, you'll notice the same person who has set a very high target for himself or herself is not able to or not wanting even to look at the target that he or she has set for herself. So these are the very clear indicators that come. But we have to definitely do the provisional diagnosis that is it going towards the anxiety disorder, depression disorder. But if it is a mood swing, then it is definitely an indicator for bipolar.
Excellent, doctor. I think these are things which everyone should watch out, especially when they are having kids around them, to look for such symptoms. And once these identified, how long the treatment can go? Especially, for example, there is a kid who's showing these symptoms of 7, 8 years or 10 years. How long this will take to correct this bipolar syndrome?
Right. So coming to this particular thing, that treatment part and how long it takes, there are different types of bipolar actually. Bipolar 1, 2, cytothyroid, which is related to the thyroid actually. So in kids, if we regularize them, with their scheduling of the day, their time management, their habits, hygiene habits, if we motivate them to follow them on a regular basis, they can come up out of it by themselves or with just a psychotherapy, or we say talk therapy. So in talk therapy also, majorly recommendations for the kids are to make them regularize or maybe a little more disciplined and be very, very precautious about the kind of the diet they are taking. Diet has to be less in carbs because diet has got some sort of effect on bipolar as well. So treatment in kids can last for if you're talking about the psychotherapy, it can just be catered in a month time, maybe 6 months to 1 year time. But in elders, it varies definitely. And it depends on the type of bipolar disorder they are undergoing. For certain bipolar 1, it will take many years. But many bipolar cases, they only need treatment when they are in a very high phase, you know, when their phase is very, very high or when they melt down. So these are only the two phases for which the medication is recommended. But as far as psychotherapy is concerned or the counselor with the psychiatrist is concerned, they definitely go ahead a little bit. But with kids, it can be early diagnosed and can be beautifully treated just with the psychotherapy itself in a couple of months. And kids can come out of it.
Doctor, I think I would like to ask you the one question which is related to the medicine, and there are all sorts of treatment which are available. So some treatment can be harmful, will show some side effect, and then there are some treatment which does not show side effect. So are there treatment available like homeopathy where the side effect may be less, it's less tedious to follow, people feel comfortable? Are there treatment available in for the bipolar in medicines like homeopathy, Ayurveda, etc.?
Yes, definitely, CK. The medication is definitely available. But it has to be there with the very good psychotherapy as well, to be very frank. Because that is a part, because the counseling is one part which can cater for the early symptoms, or maybe when the highs and lows are there, where we can train the person how to deal with it. How to deal when somebody is very, very angry. So we teach them about the deep breathing exercises and many other mindfulness techniques that are available. So we teach them. But yes, along with them, there are alternative medicines which are available, which take some time because it is a chronic illness or disorder. So it takes some time to get off. But if the triggering factor is still there, nothing will work. If somebody has got drug or alcohol abused, bipolar disorder, so I would say that they need first to be catered for their substance-induced bipolar, and then the bipolar treatment be given. Yes, in homeopathy, Ayurveda, or alternative medicines, acupuncture also is very effective in bipolar. So yes, their treatment is definitely available.
Fantastic. It was lovely talking to you, Dr. Pooja, today. And this is a very important subject. I think like any other mental disorder, we tend to overlook these symptoms and say, hey, this is part of our life, and probably he's just angry on certain things without analyzing. So I think thank you very much for giving us a lot of information on how to identify what symptoms to look at, and then how do you treat a bipolar syndrome. So with this, I'd like to say goodbye to you today. And thank you very much for finding time and coming on this show. We will catch up next week again on something more interesting for the people.
I appreciate for the opportunity, CK. Thank you so much. Stay safe.
Bye-bye, Dr. Pooja. Until next time.